Do problems when he puts millions, therefore he had to, fix those problems before starting the illness.
Sometimes people write this, write A squared minus. Like this, this x, these two negative signs will make it positive, like this. Still you get the correct answer, but the method is wrong. Not everybody, but before 2019, there were many, right? But now there are less, but if there's a problem with algebra, we need to fix it before starting the syllabus. Then it's just it's just a cakewalk after that. It's so easy after that, because if you don't make algebraic mistakes, then the rest is, as I told you, just a cakewalk, because it's very simple. Once you cover the syllabus, you can simply do the examples. You can do the even past paper problems without any difficulty. You can see it. I mean, you don't have to wait much longer to do that. பசு படங்கன்ற ஒரு பாட்டு போட்டிருக்கேன். யூ டோன்ட் ஹேவ் டு வெயிட் லோ. ஒன்ஸ் யூ ஃபினிஷ் லைக் பொலினோமியல் டுடேஸ் லெசன் நவ். ஸோ டுடே ஒன்ஸ் யூ ஃபினிஷ் த ஃபர்ஸ்ட் சாப்டர் த லைக் எக்ஸ்பேன்ஷன்ஸ் ஆஃப் த செகண்ட் ஃபேக்டரைசேஷன். ஹியர் சிம்பிளி வி கோ த்ரூ all your stuff, but the problems we do may be little more difficult than what you have encountered in O levels. Again, as I told you, there were like 12 hours are allocated for bridge the gap between O levels and A levels. With that, once you finish it, you can, like, since you are competent with the demand for algebra, you can easily do all the problems. Otherwise, once you start, like if you start making mistakes, then you cannot arrive at the solution, right? If you make very basic mistakes, right? As I told you on the other day, like when it comes to geometry, your knowledge is quite sufficient. Even you have more, you know more than what we need for the A levels. But you have done some stuff like, percentages and what else, shears and stuff like that. We don't need those here. The knowledge in statistics and probability may be so-so. It's not exactly what we need, but there's a little gap, because the exposure is a little less for you, because when it comes to probability and statistics, you cover it towards the end of the syllabus. So the time that you have been exposed to that is little less. Therefore, we do the probability and stat towards the end of the syllabus here as well. Then you will, because you have almost forgotten everything, we cover that probably 2 years from today, just before your A-levels. So probably at that time, you have probably forgotten almost everything, all the concepts when it comes to probability and statistics. But now, before that, the only thing you need is algebra, right? So at least you should be at a level so that you don't make basic mistakes, right? So that's what we are doing here. So when it comes to factorization, the first is difference between two squares, the simplest of all, right? The difference between two squares. Right? So, we take this one. If we multiply them out, like A plus B times A minus B, so you will get A times A. Then you get A times B, but it is minus B. So the sign is negative, A times B. Now you have to multiply everything by this B. So now BA, I'll write it as AB, then B times minus B, so minus B squared. Now you can see that these two will go away, right? So you, if I want, I can do this. So you get A squared minus B squared. This is true for any A and B. Therefore, if you go in the reverse direction, you can see that this is equal to this. Therefore, that's the first factorization. If you have a difference between two squares, it is not A minus B quantity squared. Like, it is not like that. It's wrong. There are certain places where you can pull out the power. You can do that when it's a multiplication or division. But if you have a subtraction or addition, you cannot do that. So it is not that. You have another factor here. I'll write A minus B first, huh? A plus B. I should have done that at the first place, like here. Shall I do it like that? Because then you can see that exactly the same copy here. If I had A minus B and A plus B, what are the changes I need to make? A times A squared. A times B, that is plus AB. Then minus B times A, that is minus AB. Then minus B squared. The order of these two have been changed. Now still they will go away, leaving this one at your disposal. So this is the answer. So A squared minus B squared can be factored like this. Now we'll do some examples. Don't take this down yet, huh? Just see. Let's start off with a very simple one. Let's have a couple of them in the same level, very basic level. These are probably the first few problems you encounter even in your O levels. Yeah. Every pair, you will be introduced at least one concept. We'll have something like this now. We'll have this for the time being. Now there are 10. I'll do some of them. Now, you should be able to do this, but don't do them now. Now let's take the very first one, part one. Usually when you do a problem like that, there are several ways that you can approach it. Now this is so simple. Like in your O levels, probably you are trained in at some level, not towards the end. But when you were introduced this for the first time, probably you were asked to do it like this, x squared minus 5 squared. So you can see that it is exactly like a squared minus b squared. So you can identify where what a and b are. But now you are an A-level student, each of you is an A-level student. Now you don't have time to write it as x squared minus 5 squared, because this is not the problem that you are going to solve. You might encounter this problem when you do a long problem, very difficult problem. You may encounter something like this in one step. So you don't have time to wait. Therefore, what you do is, you don't have to write it as x squared minus 5 squared. You can just identify it as x squared minus 5 squared. And then you think that, okay, it is x squared minus 5 squared, so it is x minus 5, x plus 5. Or sometimes you can do it like this. Sometimes people do it like this. But if you keep doing like horizontally, that may tend to make, I mean, you may tend to make more mistakes. The reason is when you are doing it like this, you are writing the next step right beneath this one. So it's like kind of close proximity. You're there. But if you do it like this, when you go further this way, when it's a small problem like this, it doesn't matter. But when it comes to a difficult problem, it matters. Because because you are going this way, what you are manipulating with is far away from what you are writing, where you write the next step. Therefore, this way, like researchers have found that this way is better. At least the probability of making a mistake is little less. Right? So this is simple. Huh? This is a simple problem. So you can do the second like this. Third. There are things called a cardinal rule. Means the main thing that you need to follow. Like, for example, when it comes to soccer, if you are not the goalie, you cannot touch the ball. Likewise, right? So it is like this. Now here, if you want to like factor this, the first thing you need to do is to, if you have a common factor, no matter what it is, it may be the difference between two squares or difference between two cube or whatever it is. If you have a common factor, you need to pull it out at first. That's a cardinal rule, no? In factoring. So there's a common factor, 3. So you get x squared minus 9. Now you can see that you can see that it is 3 squared. So you don't have to write it as 3 squared. So x minus 3 times x plus 3. Right? But I'll do the fourth as well. Later I'll give you a full set of problems for you to do, right? Fourth. Now fourth is little tricky. Not exactly tricky, but you might get trapped there. Now you can see that 36 is a perfect square. This is also a perfect square. Why? Because if you have something like this from, rule of indices, you can write it as a squared minus b squared. Like when you have a product or division, you can like distribute this power. Now, if you have 4x squared here, you can write it as the square root of 4 is 2, the square root of x squared is x, and you can write it like that. So this is also a perfect square. If you do it like that, if you take it as 2x quantity squared and minus 6 squared, you won't get the correct answer. You get some answer which is not wrong, but the factorization may not be complete. Therefore, what you need to do is that you need to pull out the common factor. That way is true. Like you can do it like this, 2x squared minus 6 squared. Then you may write it as 2x minus 6. 2x plus 6, but which is not complete because there's a common factor here, 2. There's another common factor here. Therefore, do it like this. Pull out 4. So you get x squared minus 9. Now, when it comes to 9, you don't have to write it as 3 squared. You can simply write it as like x squared minus 3 squared. So the factorization is x like factored 4 means this. X minus 3 times x plus 3. Now I don't think I need to do this. I have to do it. Because there's a pair here. Here probably you may include one step. Let me do it. I'll erase this. We don't need this. I don't do all of them, I do some of them, fifth. If I do fifth, I don't have to do the sixth. Now take this. Now here, there are two approaches that you can make. First is that you can write it as a perfect square, because some of you can do it as 2x, it is 2x squared or 2x quantity squared, right? But it's better to include this now, 2x quantity squared, because 2 squared is 4, x squared is this, minus 5 squared. Here, since you are writing the same, I mean, you have to write that, then you can write it as 5 squared. Now, you can factor a squared minus b squared. So 2x minus 5, 2x plus 5. However, I know that there are some people who can do it straight away. But I think for the time being, it's advisable to do it like this. But later you can drop this step, like towards the end, you can drop this step and write it straight away. But if you write it straight away, don't make mistakes. But I think you better go through this step, like for at least when you go through the first few problems, do it like this. Then, because that day, you know, when I do the single medium class, people made a lot of mistakes. Those who tried to do everything in one step, I mean, they are very capable students, but they made mistakes. Here, our objective here is to avoid some, like, very basic mistakes, and the second is avoid any mistake. Like, we have to avoid every mistake so that you always arrive at the correct answer. Because if you make, unlike the O-levels, like, you know, here you probably the problem you do may have 40 steps. So if you make one step, if you make one error in one step, it will propagate to the end. So that may not be very good, because then all the answers you get after that will be wrong. Right. That's why you shouldn't make any mistakes here, because you don't know, you don't realize at the first place. You may realize it towards the end, then it's too late. And if you try to correct it, you can correct it, but it will consume a lot of time in the paper. That's why you are not supposed to make any mistakes. Right? Six is, I think you can do it. You can do the sixth one. I'll do the seventh, but seventh is something that I don't want to do at this place, because it is like this. I make it to fourth power. Here also I'll make it to fourth power. x to the power 4 minus 16. I think in this case you better include that step. I mean, here I told you optional, but probably in the first few problems you can do it, but later you can drop this step. But here, for sure you can do it. You should include this step. This is a square. X to the power 4 is a square. Square of what? Right? Look. If you have something like this, what is this? This x to the power pq. You multiply these two. Again, let's take an example. If you have something like this, the idea is the following. Now, x squared is there, right? That is x times x. Cube means you need to have three of them. So, x times x, x times x. So, there are altogether six x's there. That's why you have to multiply these two. So, here, if you want to write it as a square, you divide this number by 2. So, you get x squared quantity squared, right? Minus, you can write it as 4 squared, because you are not wasting a step. Now, this is a difference between two squares. This is square of x squared, this is square of 4. Now, follow the rule, x squared minus 4, x squared plus 4. Here 4 is the square root, here the square root is x squared. Now again, if you look at this carefully, you cannot factor this one. It's a sum of two squares. Sum of two squares cannot be factored, but you can factor this again. This is something you may miss, right? So you have to do it again. So this x minus, here you don't have to write it as two squared. It is simple. If you do it, it's a waste. It's like you, if you include a step like this, that means you are wasting your time. You shouldn't go down to that level. So it is x minus 2 times x plus 2. Now here it is. 8 is similar. 9. I'll do 9. Then I'll stop. 9th problem. I'll do it here. It's okay, right? You can. So, this is square of 2x squared. This is square of 8. But don't start at that point. Why? There's a common factor here. No matter what the problem is, if there's a common factor, you should pull it out. So 4 is the common factor. So you have x to the power 4 minus 16. You exactly get what you did there. So what can you do? You have to introduce a square bracket now, because here you are going to introduce a normal bracket. Square of the x squared, 4 squared. Now, factor. This x squared minus 4, x squared plus 4. Still the story is not over. Why? You need to factor this again. So you have, I'll write it here. 4 times. No, you should write there, but if I write there, it will be probably difficult for the video. Let me see. X minus 2, x plus 2, you get x squared plus 4. Again, like in this case, you have to pull out 3. That's a common factor. Later you can see if you get something that can be factored in the parentheses, you go ahead and factor. Okay. Now, you take this down and do these problems. I did only 1, 2, 3, 4, 6 problems. You do all of them. Okay. I corrected nearly 20 scripts and I found only one person made like careless mistakes. That person knows what he was doing, but you know, it's okay. Just a couple of careless mistakes were there. Other than that, everybody has done fairly well. But these problems are not very difficult ones. We'll have another set. Here, 256 is like 16 squared. No? Right. Now go through this. Here 256 is 16 squared. Shall I do a couple of them or I just do a couple of them? Let's start with the simplest one. Like simpler one, probably the simplest of all. Now if you encounter something like this, remember the cardinal rule. You have to pull out the common factor. There's one common factor, which is y. You will be left with y squared minus 16. Now, 16 is 4 squared, but you don't have to write it. Huh? You don't waste time on that. And then you can factor this as this 4 squared, so y minus 4 times y plus 4. Second, third, fourth. Shall I do the fourth? That would be enough. X squared y squared minus 25 y to the power 4. Now here you can pull out y squared. So you'll be left with x squared minus 25. But when you pull out y squared, you get another y squared left in the with the rightmost term. Now you can see that this x squared, this 5 times y quantity squared, I don't enforce you to insert that line, but when I do the problem in the board, I should insert that because so that people can understand it better. Now this is the difference between two squares. Now you can go ahead and write it as x minus 5y, x plus 5y. When I went through the problems last time, like some of you have not listened to me, but two people, but they have got the answer in one line. All of them are correct. Therefore, I don't have any complaint. But one person haven't, who made the mistake, has not seen what I have done on the board. Like, he has not looked at that. But just learn something from this, but you can probably do it better. But when the problem, say for example, I have done fourth problem. If you copy down something totally wrong, when I have done the problem on the board, then that's a mistake. You are not supposed to do that. Like, when the answer is in front of you, don't copy down something else. But you can do the problem correctly, but you don't write something wrong when you have the answer right in front of you. Right? Okay, now do this. You can have like lesser number of steps, but you are not supposed to make mistakes. Huh? Always when you encounter a common factor, you have to pull it out. Okay. Most of you have done it great, but let me do a few, like two or three problems. Just for the others, I did. Right, just few of them. Let's take. I did the fourth, fifth. So fifth, I'll do the fifth. 4y⁴ minus 16 times x squared times x squared. Remember the cardinal rule. When it's a factorization problem, you need to pull out the common factors first. So 4 is a common factor, y squared is a common factor. So when you pull out that, it leaves y squared here, you get 4. X squared is there, but you don't have to write y squared again. Now this is 2x quantity squared. Most of you haven't inserted this step, but that is not necessary. But when I do it, I have to do it because on the board, so I should do it in a way that you should be able to understand it. But most of you haven't inserted this one, no problem, that's okay. So, but I have to do it because otherwise, for a person who is watching this, who is looking at this, may not understand. So the square root of this is y, this is 2x, this y plus 2x. I corrected nearly how many? Nearly 250 problems, or 200? Only very few mistakes. So they were just mistakes, right? I mean, sometimes you come up with the wrong answer just because you don't know what you are doing. From the answers, what I realized is that you know what you are doing, but sometimes you make a mistake. Very rarely you make a mistake. That's okay. So an insertion of this step is not necessary, but you can do it or you cannot do it. I mean, you can skip it. You can come from here to here since your standard is good. If not, if you make a mistake, then you insert this and come to the final answer. I'll do another. What about this one? 8. But most of you got correct answers for all of these. This is 8, right? X to the power 6 minus 16 x squared. So x squared can be pulled out. You should pull it out. So you get x to the power 4 minus 16. So that is something we did earlier. I mean this part. This x squared quantity squared minus 4 squared. Mainly the mistakes you have made were like this. Now this is 4 squared. So like two or three of you have like here, what should you do? You have to write x squared minus 4. Right? You don't have to get the square root again. Some of you have written 2x, like x squared minus 2. No, you have to write 4. Because a squared minus b squared. Here you should write a minus b or the square roots of these. They have taken square roots again, right? Mistakenly. So x squared minus 4, x squared plus 4. This cannot be factored, but you can factor the this one. I mean, like Britishers call it as factorize, but Americans sometimes call it as factor, just factor, factoring. Factor. X minus 2, x plus 2. So that's the final answer. That's enough, right? Because most of you have got it right. Let me write the final answers anyway for this. I did 1, so I do 2, I did 4, 5 and 8. So I do the other, I do write the answers for the other stuff. So this is simply xy minus 2, xy plus 2. The third, these are just the final answers. I did the fourth, I did the fifth, then I have to do the sixth. Sixth is that. There you can see x squared is common. So you get y squared minus 36. So y minus 6, y plus 6. Then the seventh, this one here, 5 is common. This is the final answer. I did the 8th. I'll do the 9th. Here you have to pull out the 4, like pull out 4. You get x squared minus, sorry, x to the power 4 minus 81. Tenth. Right. These are the answers for those that I haven't done. Sixth. X squared is cool, y is right. Which problem? Sixth one, this one. Here x squared is common, right? You get y squared minus 36. Rho. Because when I pull out x squared, you get x squared y squared. Yes, that's wrong. Thanks. Yeah, should be this way. Right. So those are the six answers for the problems I haven't done. Tenth. When I pull out y squared is common, you get 5. When I pull out y squared, there's another y. Yeah. Now we'll do another example. We'll do the next example from the TUT. The problems in the TUT is little, I mean, the degree of difficulty is little less than these. Okay, from the tutorial, let's do problem number 2. The answers to these problems are in page 5, right? The final answers. So if you take the sixth one, or part F, you can see that x is a common factor. You have to first pull it out. So it's x squared minus 64, which is 8 squared. So it's simpler than what we have been through earlier. When it comes to H, you can pull out 3. 3 is a common factor, as well as x squared. You'll get x squared left here, minus 9. Now you can simply factor this out. This is x minus 3, because this 3 squared, this x plus 3. In part O, you have 4 as a common factor when you look at these numbers. But when it comes to variables, you have x squared common. So x squared is left in the parentheses, minus, here you get 16. Now you can further factorize this, because it's a difference between two squares. But don't write this as 4 squared, it's unnecessary. You can simply write this as x minus 4. X plus 4. But I have seen only one mistake in part Q. Some of you have done it fairly well. Now, when you have something like this, you can see it's a perfect square. Because x squared is, I'm not talking about x squared plus 2, the quantity squared. Therefore, this is the square root of this whole thing. Minus x squared. So it is like this, you know. Like this, like a. This x is like b. So a squared minus b squared. So it's kind of straightforward, but it sometimes throws us away because it looks different than what we have encountered in previous examples. Like this little different. But even though it is different, it's straightforward, because this is just one variable. We have a square of that. Therefore, it is a minus b times a plus b. A minus b. Again, this is a plus b. B is x. If you want to have it look better, you can write it as so that the powers are in the descending order. Starting from x squared, you can write it like this. And here you can do the same thing. Right. I'll do the last one as well. X squared minus 1 quantity squared minus 4x squared. Now, this might throw us away further, because you can factor this. But that's a part of the whole expression. If you factor this, it's no use. So don't do that. Just, you can write the second one, since it's little complicated. You can possibly write this one as a square. Because when you have a product, you can pull out both exponents, this 2 squared, so you can pull out 2, leaving 2x here. Now again, a squared minus b squared. Therefore, you get x squared minus 1 minus 2x, this a, kind of a, this b. Next one, a plus b. So you can again make it look better. So you can so 2x minus 1. Here you have 2x, because you can interchange those terms. It's an addition and subtraction. So you can do it like that. You have all the final answers in the fifth page. Like we went through difference between two squares. Now, this difference between two cubes and sum of two cubes, both. Let's do them together. But they have a similar pattern, like they both have similar pattern. And this is relatively easier than the difference between two squares. Even though we are associating with cubes, this is relatively easier. Right? So part A. Two cubes, difference between two cubes. Like difference between, like it is like this, sum. Either difference between two cubes or sum of two cubes. I could have written it like this, difference between two cubes and sum of two cubes. It's longer. This way is better. So difference between two cubes. We'll have this at first. A minus B times. Let's just expand this. So when you do that, you have to multiply everything by A. So A times A squared, you get A cube. A times AB, you get A squared B. Do you need more time to do those, like 18 parts? No, right? Now, A times B squared. Now, after that, you have to multiply them by minus B. So, B times A squared. So, B times A squared, it is minus, huh? Minus B times A squared. I can write it as A squared B as well, because there are two A's, one B, A squared B. Now, when I multiply these two, you get two b's. So, a b squared, but it is minus a b squared. Now, when I multiply these two, minus and plus, so we'll get minus b cubed. Now, when you add them up, you get a cubed. These two will go away, as well as this pair, leaving a cube minus b squared there. Sorry, a cube minus b cube there. So that means if you have something like this, if you go in the reverse direction, you can factor it like this. So you have, when you have a cube minus b cube, you can write it as, I'll write cubes like this. A minus b times A squared plus AB plus B squared. Let's have the other one as well. Sum of two cubes. Again, we'll have this one. Right. Later we'll discuss them, both of them together. Now, when it comes to this, when you multiply this, you get a cube. When you multiply these two, you get a squared b. Here you get plus ab squared. Now, starting off with the second one, you get a squared b. I'll write that beneath this one, a squared b. Now when I multiply these two, you get minus a times b squared. Finally, the product of these two, b times b squared. So you get b cubed. Now when you add them up, these two will go away. What about this pair? That will go away. So you're leaving a cubed plus b cubed. So you can write this as a cube plus b cube is equal to the product of these two, a plus b times a squared plus ab plus b squared. Now look, you have a cube minus b cube here, the first result. How do you get this one? It is not as easy as what we went through earlier. Like difference between two squares, the factored form is relatively easier. But here it's different. There are two of them. So how can we deal with them? How can you remember them? Like look, there are two of them. Quite similar. But not exactly the same. So how do you remember them? How do you memorize them? This is how you do it. When you have a cube and a cube minus b cube, you close these cubes. Then what do you see? You see a minus b. That is the first factor. Close this. What you see is a minus b. That becomes the first factor. Is it true for the next one? We'll see. Here, when it is a cube, like when you encounter a cube plus b cube, you close this. What do you see? A plus b. That becomes your first factor. After that, once you know what the first factor is, you can go ahead and write the second. How? You take this, what is sitting here, the number you see, number, the expression, whatever. What you see here can be squared. Here you have b, forget about this minus sign, b, you square it, right? As the rightmost term, leftmost term is the square of this, rightmost term is the square of b. Now get the product of them, don't try 2a. But there are some signs, forget about them. Do you have the same pattern there? Of course, yes. Because this is a and b, when you square this, you get a squared. The leftmost term in the second factor can be written just by squaring this. Now, square this, you get b squared. In the middle, you have ab product. Now, very similar, the terms are very similar. However, here all of them are positive. There, I made a mistake, right? It should be minus. It should be minus. What is the same? Look, I have made a mistake when I copy that down. You have minus sign. Now, they are different. The signs are different. So how do you figure that out? This is how you do it. Now, you know what the first factor is. Just by deleting these two, you can get the first factor. In every case, in each case, you can do it like that. When it comes to the second factor, you know these three terms, right? However, you are just not sure, you're not very sure about these signs. Signs are coming like this. Right? Look, in the first factor, plus minus, right? That means sign changes. If in one factor the sign is changed, don't change the sign of the other factor. If this is plus minus, if the sign changes, because you exactly know what the first factor is. Since the sign is changed, here don't change the sign. Now go for the second one. You know what the first factor is. You know how to write these three. But we are not sure about the sign, plus or minus. We are not sure. But look, here sign doesn't change. Plus plus. Sign is fixed. In this factor, sign is fixed. But here, what should you do? You should alternate the sign, like plus, minus, plus. You left, right, left, like you alternate the sign. Plus, minus, plus. Okay? Here, you alternate the sign because you already get that once you close the three numbers, number three, or the exponents, you get A minus B. So here sign changes, or sign alternates, plus, minus. Here, sign doesn't alternate. Always it is positive. Here, sign doesn't alternate, therefore here you should alternate the sign. Simple. Now we'll do some examples. We'll first take difference between two cubes. Huh? We'll do some simpler ones first. Right. So let's take a few of them. The first. Right. So I'll do it in my way, because I want to like give some steps in between. But here you know that it is 2 cube. But I write it like this. I don't force you to write that, but it will be easy for. If I write it like this, I can easily explain you what's going on. There are 2 factors here. How do you get the first factor? Just close these cubes. You get x minus 2. Now you can come up with the second factor. Second factor is obtained like this. You square this. That will give you the leftmost term. Now square this one. 4. Forget about this minus sign. Just square 2. Even with minus 2, you get 4. But just take this 2, you get 4. Now take the product. This product of these two, forget about the sign. Product of these two, 2x. It is in between. Now what about the signs? Here sign alternates, plus minus. Therefore, in the other factor, sign should be fixed. Always plus, plus, plus. Always positive. That's all. So you don't need that formula if you do it like that. Should I do the second? No, I'll do the third. X cube y minus y. Here you know the cardinal rule is you have to pull out y first. It's a common factor. One is the cube of one. One times one times one is one. If you want, you can write it like this. I'll do it that way so that I can explain you better. So if I close this, if I delete the powers, what you see is 6 minus 1. So the first factor becomes 6 minus 1. How do you do this? How do you come up with the second factor? Again, that rule. You get the leftmost term by squaring this, get the rightmost term. It is 1 squared, it is 1. Now the product of these two is x. Now what about the signs? Here the sign alternates, plus, minus. Therefore in the next one, no alternation. You just write, I mean keep it fixed, plus, plus, plus. Then let me do the fourth. That would be enough. Now here, you have 8x cubed, minus 1. Now 8x cubed can be, because 8 is 2 cubed, this x cubed. So you can write it like this. Because 2 to the power 3 is 8, x to the power 3 is x cubed. You can do it like that. Here it is 1 cubed. So that I can explain you better. So now if you close this powers, indices, what you get is 2x minus 1. So the first factor is 2x minus 1. The second factor, you have to square this. You can do it, it is 4x squared. Right. Since I am explaining this on the board, I should insert one term in addition, but you don't have to do it when you write. But I should, for the sake of explanation, I should insert it here. But you can skip that step. 2x squared, quantity squared, you get this. 1 squared is this. Then the term in the middle is the product of these two. Now here, since the sign alternates in the second factor, sign doesn't alternate. You have to keep it fixed. Now it is 2x minus 1. Now this, 4x squared plus 2x plus 1. I think you can skip. Instead of this, you should be able to write 4x squared. But for the sake of explanation, I have to insert that so that everybody understands what's going on. Now do everything. I did 3, you do all 8. Here you can pull out the common factor. In this 8, you can pull out the common factor. as I told you, you know, there are no mistakes, because usually people do this better. I have to insert more steps because I want to make sure that everybody understands. But in the process, you can possibly, you know, reduce some steps. So here you.
Those are the final answers. So we'll take like 5 minutes to do the other seat. What is it? Sum of two cubes. This is the answer to the eight. But I didn't do any problem which demands putting out a factor. So I think I should do this using the other part, the third part. Therefore, it is not necessary. So we will do another set with sum of two cubes. In the same game, like very similar to what we did earlier. So I do the first, music, then I do the third, and the fourth. That would be sufficient. First, x cubed plus 27. You can write 27.
As before, as in the previous case, you know, you find the very first term.
write the right positive line, the square of 3, then you write the product of these two in between. Now, here signs are fixed. So in the same factor, signs should dominate. It's very similar to the first one.
So you
you close these cubes, you get the first factor. The second factor can be obtained using this. So first square this, then you get the leftmost term. When you square this, you get 4y squared. Then the term in the middle, you can get it as a product of these two, 2xy. However, when it comes to signs, here the signs are fixed. Therefore, in the second factor, signs should already plus, minus, plus. That's the answer to the seventh part. You can try the problems, but there are nine. Problem 3 of the tube. There are only 9 parts. Okay. So next class, we need to go through trinomials before getting into expansions. Okay. So we need to go through the basic stuff at least for 3 or 4 days, then we can start the lesson. Once you start the lower A-level stuff, I mean, you will be able to, like, once you finish it, you will be able to hold, like, past paper problems or whatever without any difficulty. Then you experience it, then we can continue there. But before that, I can say various things, but you don't have to believe. But once we finish the first section, you can see that you can easily do these problems without anybody saying. So before getting into that, we need to go through some, you know, we need to brush up those the things that we are not sure, the gray areas of algebra, and at the same time we need to do problems so that we